I pray thee once again. I wonder if it's surrounded by ones of such talent.
How did you come up with the name Payote?
It's a great one, actually. One of my good friends gave me that name right before he went on a journey of his own. He looked at me and he says, "I'm gonna call you Payote from now on." I said, "Well, that's interesting. I don't hate it, but why?" He says, "'Cause you're a trip, but with the spiritual side." And I was like, "All right, I dig it. So it's kind of how it became, and stuck from there, and it just kind of grew like wildfire.
Awesome. So describe spray art to you. What is spray art, and what makes you different from other spray artists?
I don't know if I'm any different, really. I've gone through some of the same challenges, and I'm still learning some of the same things that other people are learning. So, as far as different, I think just what sets me aside is my own style, my own touch. I mean, my own ideals, the way my mind works to be able to create the things. I'm trying to look for the most simplistic way, and the quickest, and yet the most elaborate. So I'm trying to have the quality of some of the best aspects you can possibly, you know, ask of yourself, and then be able to go from there.
So, who influenced you?
That's a great question. As far as spray paint artists go themselves, there's quite a few. One of the first was, I'm not sure if this is actually the guy's name, but you can catch a few of his videos on YouTube. It's Las Rombolas, I believe. He's an older head, just always happy, singing, whistling on the beach, or he was whistling in, I believe it was like New York City, kind of. It may have been Europe. Actually, it was. Start that all over again. He was in Barcelona, and he'll be sitting there just whistling, having a good time, enjoying himself, and taking his time, doing 30-minute paintings or so, just really focused on detail. So I think he was one of the first real big influences, and then I've been able to be blessed to work with guys like Mark Fussell. Definitely an inspiration. Definitely helped me out with my galaxies and stuff, and helped me slow down as well. Other than that, there's great people like Darren Tyree, Scott Gibson, Alex Peck. They're a bunch of really great, influential spray paint artists that are out there. So,
would you describe your art as a business, love, passion, or all three?
That's a good question. I'd say probably all three, because I'm very business mindset. I like to stay busy and everything. It's definitely a passion. It's something that I don't get tired of very easily.
That's really neat.
I love entertaining. I love performing.
I think it's going to be one thing. It ends up being something completely different.
People, you know, kind of come out of their shell and smile and have fun and lighten up. And, you know, that's all part of the job. So I think that's one of the best parts of it. And then, of course, the passion to just grow and be as good as I possibly can be is definitely the fine end goal. But it's a journey that I'm enjoying. You know, not looking forward to just reaching the end and not knowing where to go from there, so.
I am told that your art has been purchased from people all around the world. Mm-hmm. What are some of the countries that we can add to your list?
Oh man, definitely, just Africa. I've had six went to Pakistan probably about a month ago. France, Canada, plenty to go to Canada, actually. Down South America, I've actually got a buddy, shout out to Aquamarine. He's from Croatia. Supposed to be shipping him one here shortly. So, just being blessed to be able to work in Virginia Beach, and it's a great tourist town. Allows a lot of people to come to me versus me trying to go to them. So, by all means, that's how it starts. And then shipping, of course, is always available. So, try to send them as far as they'll go.
So, how much would I have to budget to purchase one of your pieces of art?
Ah, man, well, so you helping me out with this beautiful documentary here. So by all means, of course, we're gonna hook you up, man. It's all about love, spreading love and art. So by all means, not about me trying to make millions, but it all depends on the quality and size of work that you would like. You know, I got pieces that start for in the streets at like $10, going all the way up to fine pieces that are on huge canvases that I've taken maybe 7-8 hours on, and you know, ask a few hundred, you know, up for those. So by all means, I'm trying to get into the realm of fine art with the spray paint and performance art. I'm trying to be the art of fine art and be able to do some gallery work as well.
I'm aware that you have a vast love for a variety of music. Mm-hmm. How does your music connect with your artwork?
Oh man, so many ways. Just between the mood alone is a good way to set it up. Be able to, whatever I'm feeling, it just correlates with the flow of energy and life and, you know, everything like that. And then also just being able to dictate the flow of feeling and emotions. If people are having a bad day, you're able to cheer them up by just throwing on a good song, you know. So I think that just being able to use it as a tool, you know, is one of the best ways that music is.
It's nice. Speaking of connection, what kind of people do you connect with?
Everybody, man, everybody. From people that come by every day and clean up the trash and I get to say what's up to them, to, you know, the top guys that I go party with and you know, that I you know, try to build my business with and support groups, and you know, I got a great team. Shout out to my A team, man. Shout out to them for sure.
So, who is and who are your best friends or friends?
Some of my best friends are Antoine and Chloe. I believe he met them the other day. And kind of friends all over, man. I go few and far between for the quality, I'd say. And so it's definitely, you know, my friends out there, they all know it's all love. And it's just, you know, we may not see each other every day, and we get to still, you know, understand that it's quality. And I don't know how to answer that question, I guess. It's a tricky one.
Tell us something you want us to know about.
I'm extremely grateful for the people that have pushed me to keep going. Just the simple people that have come by and said, hey man, keep doing what you're doing. Like, they're those people, man. I definitely want to give you guys a shout out, because, you know, my mantra is another beautiful day, and I try to, you know, tell myself that to make sure every day is the best it possibly can be.
I bring a friend.
But at the same time, man, I'm human too. Some days just aren't that good, so by all means, man, people that have told me, hey, just keep going. It's mad.
Going to Woodstock.
So, what is the theme of your artwork?
The theme right now, really, lately I've been still building my skills to get them just on point. With critiquing them, refining them over and over and over again. So right now, the main theme is to start thinking about my message and the message that I'll be bringing and delivering. So I want that to be passionate and strong and powerful. So by all means, I think that's where it's headed.
So how do you want us to remember you?
Man, that's a good question. Definitely for, you know, the simple stuff, man. I've been able to be blessed to have a simple life, simple job. And so basically by, you know, just keeping it simple, you know.
What drives you to want to get up most days and perform and make fabulous art?
Just the unknown of what's going to happen. And also just the curiosity of what can I create today, you know, what else, what new, where can I push myself, where can I step out of my bounds and be able to, you know, take it to another level, whether it's good or bad, or I feel like it maybe, you know, I could have done better or whatever, just being able to have that experience and opportunity to make the most out of it and take advantage of each day is kind of what motivates me.
Interesting. When you're not performing, how do you chill? What is a normal day like for Payote?
Chill, I mean, that's where the beach comes in, by all means. The beach is just between surfing and, you know, relaxing hard. I mean, it's a pretty easy life, so. But actually, my day off is today, and I'm actually probably working twice as hard as I am. I got less sleep last night than I have all week, so by all means, it's my days off aren't always as chill as I'd like them, but this is the season, man. This is what we live for. So by all means, winter time is a good time to chill and take it easy. Right now, living life, man.
Last but not least, tell us something we don't know about you.
I already told you, like, I'm a hopeless romantic, so that's like some random fact. Another random fact would be, I was that kid in school that was always late for class and maybe causing a little bit of trouble in the back of the class. I was that kid. So that was always me. I was always, you know, just kind of stirring up something. I grew up skateboarding and stuff like that. So by all means, So this is my way to kind of still be a rebel and give them hell and from this side, you know, and still do my own thing and kind of contribute to society in some sense.
Payote, it's been great, brother. Sitting here, chilling with you. Hey, man, look, I'm going to add you to my do something great with it. What about, let's go surfing or maybe skydiving? Or do you game?
A little bit on the game, and my buddy Antoine's getting me more into it, but by all means, surfing, skydiving, man, yeah, I'm definitely down with that. I love anything action-packed. I was in the other store, I forget the name of the shop, but basically there's some motorcycles. I was in there kind of browsing yesterday, so motorcycles, anything extreme, and top-notch, man, I'm with it. I love it.
All right, well, it's been a pleasure speaking to you, and enjoy taking extra time.
You, man. Appreciate you.
Story of my life, ordinary person just like you. If you take a look inside, you see the great things that people do. We're out here changing lives day and night, day in, day out. BBC don't show, CNN don't show it. Ease up.